Hello, I'm Helen Cummins and I'm here today with Sue Shim, coming all the way originally from Korea, now living in Canada, working in a very important corporate career, and she finds herself here in Mallorca. And we're delighted to welcome her here today. Hello, Sue. You're very welcome. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
So nice you're here. What brought you to Mallorca?
Well, you know, initially it was just starting as I needed somewhere to go during the holidays in December, winter in Montreal, just to get away. And then in the middle of COVID, right? So I was looking for the place, and mostly we go to Miami, but like been there, done that. No. So I was looking for something different. And then some of my friends just mentioned like two times in a row, like, how about Mallorca? So like, Mallorca? Where? What is this? Like, isn't it like Spain, you know? So I started searching, like, okay, maybe let me learn about this. Mallorca, Google. And then, of course, ABC Mallorca showed up, like constantly showing so much good information.
Great.
And then I found out that, wow, it sounds like it's a place that I've been looking for.
Yeah.
Not just for vacation, actually in general, like I was looking for a place I want to move and settle down and for long term. So I was like, I need to check this out. And then that's how I actually reached out to you. I'm like asking
through the Helen Cummins website.
Exactly.
And the Mallorca Living
Center. Yes, I saw a lot of videos and information from, you know, your company, and then it was like fascinating. So I wanted to talk to you and then check it out. Like, how can I get there and then settle down? So it was like starting with the holiday, where I'm going to spend my Christmas holiday, to the, maybe I actually might find a place I can live.
Okay.
So let's go explore.
Okay,
that's
super.
That's when we
ended up speaking over Zoom one day.
Yeah.
And then you said that you were coming here for a month.
And that was such a comforting factor because, you know, Mallorca, I don't know where even it is. I don't know anybody there, and like random picking. But then when I just saw you on Zoom, it's like, oh my God, it's a real person, such a welcoming warmth. And like, yeah, I think I can get there and then start.
Okay. So you booked an Airbnb for the month, you booked your flight, and you arrived here mid-December 2021. So what has it been like?
Oh my God, it has been so wonderful. Like, I feel like, you know, sometimes you're like in the movie, you don't even realize. I'm a character in the movie, and it's like movie director created the whole thing, and I'm just acting out, and all things are planned out almost. Just that's kind of how it was. A lot of synchronicity and like almost messages and signs that were connecting. It's just a bit crazy, sounds like crazy, but that's how I have been feeling. It has been amazing. I mean, coming to Mallorca in the middle of December, just I thought that it would be cold, so I was a bit worried. But when I arrived, oh my God, the weather was so perfect. So, and then also because Christmas time, everything was decorated so beautifully. I was like a kid in the candy store, like, oh my God.
And it felt like Christmas for you.
Yeah. It was so
nice. It's a little bit different than going somewhere super warm, but yet it was sunny and nice.
Exactly. It had both. And then also like initially I was worried about spending actually holiday quietly, kind of sadly alone. So I was really open to look for people to meet. And then that's what I did. Like I really tried to connect with the new people, and so that I can celebrate this Christmas and New Year together.
And you've mentioned to me a few times that you found the people here in general very, very open. So what was your experience like trying to connect with people here?
Yes, so I really got to meet all kinds of people. So initially I thought, okay, maybe I'll go meet some expats because I heard a lot of Europeans move here and live, international people. And that was definitely given. But I ended up meeting like really Mallorca, the local, and made friends.
Yeah. Great.
And then also Spanish people from Madrid and others, and international people, also young people from 24 years old all the way to 74 years old. And people, I'm kind of a corporate person, right? But I got to meet people from all different areas because I'm kind of into yoga. So ended up meeting people from more spiritual community or, you know, different kind of group of people.
But you did mention it takes one thing when you come here, right? If you want to meet people. And that is that I think you came with the idea of being very open, you know, and to even maybe push yourself a little bit outside your normal comfort zone.
Yes, exactly. So I actually set the intention. Whenever I do the yoga, I set the intention. I said, please let me be open so that I can meet the people who are filled with love. So that was like kind of my prayer. And because I was a bit scared too, because like, oh, you know, I'm going to be alone, I'm going to meet any people. So like unknown, but I let me be open. So the other thing I did that when the thought comes to you, it's weird, I don't want to do this, you know, that first thought. Then when I catch that thought, they say, okay, then I have to say yes.
So you force yourself. Yes. Okay, I'm going to do it, even though it sounds a bit strange.
Right, that's it.
Okay. You've equated your journey a few times to the wonderful book and movie, Eat, Pray, Love. Yes. Tell me why. Why do you?
So I was almost jokingly said, hey, why did you come to Mallorca? So I told people, oh, I came here to do the Eat, Pray, Love all at once in one place. You know?
Okay.
So I kind of felt that there's a lot of city scene with the culture and the cuisine and Spanish food, of course, eat. And then I'm into yoga, so let's go do a lot of yoga spiritual practice. So it's kind of pray. And then let's meet a lot of loving people. So filled my life with love. So that was like kind of summarizing my Eat, Pray, Love. But then I think my movie title will not be just EPL, Eat, Pray, Love. It will be more Eat, Pray, Love and Cura.
So tell me about the significance of Cura for you. So Cura is a place of Mallorca, which you actually, you visited, you found yourself in Cura, which is not a typical place to find yourself in the middle of winter.
Yeah.
So tell me, how did you arrive there?
So that's one of the things that I did, like being open-minded. So there was supposed to be some sort of a folk music concert. So I was curious, okay, what is this about? Mallorca folk music. So I opened to go there. It was in the middle of nowhere, and then I didn't know how to get there. So somehow organizer connect me with a Mallorca grandmother to go there without speaking language to each other. And then once I got there, I didn't know how to come back. So, because I didn't have a ride back. And then I found the people at the concert, anybody going back to Palma. So I ended up connecting with those local people mm-hmm. who drove me back. But on the way, they actually took me to this Cura place on top of the mountain. And then we had a really nice conversation and connection made. Then I kind of asked them, where are we? And then they said, it's a Cura. And what does that mean? And it's cure, healing. And I realized that I was in the process of that healing journey here. Wow. Like I didn't come here to heal myself because I didn't think I needed it. But I think there was still a lot of things I needed to resolve, especially what happened in last year, my father passing away. And then I guess this was kind of part of that journey that I still needed to do. And also I met a lot of people doing similar things here, actually, you know, they're kind of seeking some sort of answers or trying to heal themselves in a certain way. And then I end up connecting with a lot of people. I think we're all kind of in a way suffering.
Yes, so, after the last couple of years. And one of the places I recommended to you when I heard you were coming was Sadhana Works, the School of Consciousness here in Palma. Can you tell me about your experience there? Because I think that the connection to healing and yes. Sadhana Works was quite significant for
exactly.
you.
Exactly. Actually, that becomes the center of everything in a way, actually. So yoga always grounds me. And then that's good that you recommend me that studio. But I went there with open-minded, but I wasn't sure what it is. But then I fell in love right away. This place was like so special. And I met a lot of friends there, but also the founder and the teacher,
Mariana.
It's just amazing. And yeah, she was teaching Kundalini yoga, which I'm like not familiar with. I'm a yoga teacher, but I'm in a different kind. So I said, okay, something I don't know, so I gotta try it out. And then that's where kind of healing journey began in a way, because so much thing was releasing within me. And just it was wonderful. And it was in the center, really convenient. So it was very close to my home. So I felt like I was in a retreat in the middle of a city because I wake up in the morning early. You know, it's really quiet. You walk there, you do the nice practice of yoga, or sometimes even do it at night. So, you know, after that, you just have all this energy, positive energy and love filled. so I can go out, meet the people, and then make this new connection and the magic.
Beautiful.
So.
And the other place you found very useful was on Facebook. So you did the research, you checked out different groups, and then you connected with them. What were the best experiences from the Facebook group?
Normally I don't use Facebook that much, but this is really useful for travelers. I think you go there and find the group.
Actually, it works really well in Mallorca.
Exactly. So I didn't even know that. And also, like, when I checked it out, there were so many groups they can choose from. And then I went with my own interest, right? So I wanted to find like-minded people. So some yoga, spiritual related group, or woman traveling. So there's a girl gone international Mallorca.
Okay.
So that's the other one is a really digital nomad, which is a really big thing and growing group here
in Mallorca.
A lot of people are coming here to really start working remotely, which is amazing. All international people. So that was one of my favorite groups because I end up getting a lot of information and also connections. So like these are kind of three probably most used groups that I used.
Okay, and when you go back to Canada, what will you be telling your friends about Mallorca, about your experience of exploring and discovering Mallorca?
Mallorca, it has everything.
This is what you kept hearing, right? Everybody kept telling you.
Yes,
Mallorca has everything.
So I was feeling that and thinking that, and then I verified that because whenever I talk to people, so what brought you to Mallorca and how long you've been here? And then they all end up, and then why did you stay? And they all said, it has everything. Oh my God, you said that, you said that. Everybody says same line. So you should have like a bumper sticker on the
Mallorca.
It has everything.
Super. So does that now, after meeting all these people, and we always recommend for people to come and, you know, try the place, have the experience, and then really make a decision whether it's, if Mallorca could be a place that you'd consider living. I think in your case, you really fell in love with Palma also, the city of Palma. So what is your feeling now, 5 weeks later?
I'm in love. So I wrote it to my friends like, hey, I met her and I was curious to know more about her. I wanted to understand. I wanted to know everything about her. I'm like, who is she? And like, her name is Mallorca. And that's exactly how I feel. And I'm looking forward to coming back in summer because I already learned a lot about that. I actually like winter in Mallorca and Palma. And then I also realized that I really do like a city, Palma. Probably that's where I want to live because I like the culture side of it and good food as well. So, but I do also want to come back in summer and experience how it is like that and then really realizing where is the best location overall the whole seasons. So that's what I will do. I will come back and then I'm looking forward to like finding a more permanent home.
Okay, well, brilliant. Well, I hope we can help you in your journey, Sue. It's been so wonderful to meet you. I still can't believe it was kind of just over Zoom we met because we've had so many wonderful times together in the last month.
Yes.
So from my heart to yours, I really wish you all the best in your journey and I hope we'll see lots more of you in the future.
Thank you so much for all the advice and then actually lots of love and connection you made for me.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
You.